If you are new, please go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button and turn on post notification bells. By the title, you guys already know what I'm finna say. The time has finally come. Well, did come, but honestly, I wish I would have got my labor and delivery video recorded, but it was just too much going on. So let's get into the video. So I honestly don't remember what day I went into the hospital, but here is how I induced my labor. Like I said, I don't remember the day at all, but me and my sister, we were 2 days apart. Our due dates were 2 days apart, and I was trying to induce my labor multiple times. I've tried castor oil by itself with orange juice. I've tried working out. I've tried walking, pineapples, and nothing seemed to work. So I had seen this thing online where it's called midwife's brew, and I wanted to try it. I was kind of hesitant on it because I was watching videos, and some of the videos weren't like good videos, I guess. They were just showing how they drunk it and it just went into contractions and then the video would cut off. This is the recipe. So we went and we got the stuff, and while both of our baby daddies were out getting stuff, we had did this video. It was an exercise, it's called activating labor. I'm gonna put up a little clip of that. This is the clip. It's called activating labor. So while they were out getting the ingredients, we were at the house doing that video. We did it 2 times. I was tired as hell. I couldn't breathe. And mind you, I'm bigger than her. How? I don't know. I thought he was gonna come out huge as hell, but I guess not. After the video, we had made the stuff and I was scared. She was scared kinda. So we drank it. You're supposed to drink it under 30 minutes to an hour. So it took us a whole hour to drink that. The first few sips, it wasn't that bad. It was okay. It smelled good to me, blah, blah. But after like the fifth or sixth gulp, that shit tasted nasty. I couldn't drink it without throwing up. And in the middle of us drinking it, she had already started having contractions. Mind you, she's due before me. So her contractions started instantly. My contractions started within like 2 hours after. I was still having contractions and they were getting intense. They were getting worse. So I'm thinking like, oh my God, this is working. This is happening. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I was happy as hell. But at the same time, I was scared and I was nervous because I was like, I think I induced my labor. I was ready, but I wasn't ready. He was finna leave to go get us something to eat. And I was like, when you come back, if the contractions get any worse, just take me to the hospital. But then he was like, okay. So 2 minutes later, I was like, no, just take me now. Take me now, take me now. So we went, and I had, of course, they're like, you know, they have you pee in a cup and all the other crap. So I was having labor contractions. I was 2 centimeters dilated, and they were gonna send me home because my water did not break. But literally when she hopped on the phone with my doctor and said, you know, her water didn't break, but she's 2 centimeters dilated and she is having labor contractions, my water broke. My baby daddy had to go back to the house and get our hospital bag and the car seat because we wasn't sure if they were gonna keep me or not. We're still checking me. They had me on Pitocin to induce my contractions and everything. And we were there for like 2 days. So he was born May 22nd. He was 8 pounds, 5 ounces, 21 inches, born at 12:34 p.m. So the whole time I was there, they had me on Pitocin. I did 7 liters, up to 7 liters of fluid to induce my labor. Well, pop the rest of my bag, I guess. Cause I was leaking. But I guess my bag wasn't popped all the way. My doctor had came in, Dr. Gordon, he had came in and he was like, okay, let's check. So he had his nurse check me and she was like, your I was still 2 centimeters dilated the whole 3 days. Well, 2 days we were there. I was still 2 centimeters dilated. I was not going up. I was not going down. So they checked me and she was like, oh, you're 4 centimeters dilated. I was like, yes. Cause once you get close to 6 centimeters dilated, it can go fast as hell for you to give birth. So I was happy. I was like, okay, great. I'm 4 centimeters dilated. She's like, and I feel no bag. And I'm like, okay, great. So everything is pop. So I'm excited because I'm like, okay, we finna have to push real soon because it goes by real quickly after this. No. I don't know what she felt, but another doctor had came in like 2 hours after her, and she was an African lady and she was black, and she said, okay, the Pitocin were up in your dosage and you're just not contracting, like you're contracting, they're back to back, but we don't know what's going on. So she said, let me check you myself. So she checked me and she was like, I still feel a bag. And I'm like, huh? I thought my water bag broke. She said, no, it's a bag in there. So I'm gonna pop it. I wasn't prepared for that. I wasn't, cause she stuck a needle up there and it popped, and it felt like I just had a lot of water. Like I just peed out almost the whole ocean. That's what it felt like. I was planning on doing labor naturally. No epidural, no nothing, but I bullshit you not. As soon as she popped my water bag, 5 minutes later, them contractions that was supposed to happen 2 days ago started happening within 5 goddamn minutes. I felt everything. I was like, oh no, epidural. Give me the walking epidural, please. It went quickly from there. Once I guess I was still 2 centimeters, boom, I hit 4. Within the next hour, boom, I hit 6. Within the next hour, boom, I hit 8. My last nurse, her name was Kelly, and she was like, okay, you're 8 centimeters dilated, and it's almost time for you to push. But she said, you'll know when it's time for you to push because it's going to feel like you have to take a big dookie. So I'm like, okay. So I'm trying to, like, you know, feel out for that feeling, but also at the same time I'm contracting, which hurt like hell. Eventually, the time came where I was like, I had to tell my my fiance. I said, look, you got to call her, tell her to come back in. He called her. He was like, she needs you. And as she came in, I said, Kelly, I think it's time. And then she was like, okay, let's check. So she checked last time. She was like, you're 10 centimeters. It's time to start pushing. My baby daddy looked. He said, huh? Wait, what? Like the real type of push? I'm looking at him like, what other push is it? It's finna happen now. I didn't know how I was supposed to push a baby out. I didn't know where to begin. And two, my epidural wore off. So it's like I went into labor exactly how I wanted to, naturally. So I was finna feel everything. She was like, your first 4 pushes, I promise after that it's gonna get easier. And she was right, because after my first 4 pushes, it made it easier to push him out. But my last 4 or 5 pushes, it was hard because he had got stuck. Like his head and everything was out, but when it came to like his shoulders and everything, he was kind of like, you know, stuck. So that's where it hurted. And I felt like I was telling him as I'm pushing, I'm tearing. Like I can feel my area tear. So once he came out, I started crying. I'd seen him getting cleaned up and everything, and baby, I just started crying. My baby daddy, I don't know what he was doing. He was just over there looking. I don't know if he was crying. I was just all over the place. I was looking around. I was crying. The doctors, everything was all up in my face while they're getting him clinked off. And it was just a lot of, it felt like it was a lot of people in there, but it really wasn't. He's such a good baby. This time, I hope everybody stays safe. God bless everybody, and I will see y'all. We will see y'all in the next video.